You think you may have a valid medical malpractice or accident case in New York, and now you're looking to hire an attorney. But wait a second. Did you know that when you go to look for an attorney, the attorney is deciding whether or not to hire you? Would you like to learn what I mean? Come join me and I'll explain. Hi, I'm Jerry Ojinski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury trial attorney practicing law here in the state of New York. The reality is that although you are looking for an attorney to represent you in your malpractice or wrongful death or accident case, when you walk into an attorney's office or you first pick up the phone to call, the attorney is actually deciding whether to work with you and accept you as a client. And that's a critical distinction. And although you have many choices, many attorneys to handle your particular matter here in New York, the key question that an attorney will always have, and this is something that goes through my mind all the time when I speak to new potential clients, and I'm going to share with you a few key points to keep in mind so that you have a true understanding of what an attorney looks for in a potential client. One of the first things that I look for when somebody comes into my office is, are they credible? Are they believable? Is what they are saying, does that make sense? And if it doesn't, then there may be a problem. Second, I want to know, do we get along? Because if we don't get along from the outset, then there's going to be a problem. Remember, these types of cases last anywhere from 2 to 3 years from start to finish. And if I know at the immediate outset that there's a problem, then that relationship is in all likelihood not going to be a good one. And I'm going to tell you right up front. I'll tell you, listen, I don't think this is going to work out for us. There are other attorneys that I think you should go to. Next, I want to know, what's the liability in the case? I want to know, what's the extent of the damages? I have to evaluate and investigate your entire matter. And if I think that there's a problem there, I'm going to come right out and tell you. The next thing I want to know is, are you willing to keep an open mind? Are you willing to accept my advice? Now, you ultimately have the decision on whether to accept it or reject it. But the key thing to remember is, I have a bit of experience. I've been doing this now going on 24 years. And there are some people who simply refuse to accept anything an attorney says. Why? Because they think they know better. And they may, but in all likelihood, unless they do this type of work every single day, there's a good chance that they probably want to get some good professional advice from somebody who handles these types of cases on a daily basis. So why do I even give you this information? I give you this information just to give you an insight and to recognize that just because you're looking for a particular attorney to handle your matter, doesn't necessarily mean that the attorney is going to believe that you're the right one for them. So literally, it's as if you're applying for a position, you're applying for a job or for a slot to become a trusted client in our office. And that's pretty much it for today, just to give you an idea and an insight into what happens into the selection process when we decide whether or not to take you on as a client. Chances are, you're watching this because you have questions or concerns about which attorney is right for you. Well, if you have questions, what I want you to do is pick up the phone and call me. I answer questions like yours every single day. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at lawmed10@yahoo.com. I'm Jerry Ojinski here in New York. Thanks for watching.